Hey, this is awesome. What do we got today? This, if you haven't guessed by now, is definitely a Lexus. I don't know if you recall, Lexus first came over to the United States about 1990, I believe it was, with the LS400. And in 1991, you could have also bought the little smaller Lexus. And this would have been known as the ES250. It has a lot of JDM styling cues. Basically, it's a glorified Camry. But you know what? It was still Lexus for its day. And people bought it up. They loved them. You know, they thought it was better than a Camry, which in a lot of ways it was. So I'm going to go around this car real quick and tell you a little bit about it. These trunk hinges are messed up, which I notice happens on a lot of these cars. But I'm sure it's fixable. And let's see what else we got. I'll look in the trunk here. It's a little dirty in there. But it's a super solid, straight Arizona car. I believe the paint is original. The tires are in good shape. It's unmolested. By that I mean it's not been modified at all. This outer door handle is not working, so I had to reach in and do it. The leather's not too bad. Floor mats are dirty. Interior's I'll probably clean up some of it, but it probably could use a good scrubbing. It's not all falling apart, except for right there is the worst of it, from what I can tell, as far as the interior goes. Now, we're gonna get to other things in a second, like engine and stuff like that. It's a 2.5 liter V6. Let's see here. All nice radio and stuff. That works. Chili peppers. AC works. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it works. Hang on. AC. Let's see if it gets cold. I'm pretty sure it gets cold. Are they cold for a second? There's your glove box. There's AC buttons on it. It's cold now. It's got a lot of gas in it. It's fresh. Tach works. Leather's a little hard, but it's not unbearable. Arizona's been a little difficult on the leather, but not horrible. Sunroof, that's nice. Again, I haven't tried to see if it works. I guess I could try. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, sunroof works. Okay, dome light probably works. Maybe I just have it on the wrong setting. That works. Figure out what's going on there. Anyway, more about the interior. Fold down back seats, which are kind of neat. Again, needs a little bit of vacuuming, some cleaning up there. But for 1991, this car has really stood up pretty well. AC is getting cold. Here we go. All right. AC works. It does need some work cosmetically. It does need some work mechanically. I'll get to more of that also in a second. After I go over these interior a little bit. Sorry I didn't totally clean it out today. I think some nice leather conditioner would be really nice for this. And did I pop trunk? Trunk. Whew. Spares under there, all tidy and stuff. No rust under here, as you can expect. Again, nice Arizona car with no accidents that I could tell. Close trunk. Hang on, I'm gonna close this. Now I'm gonna close it again. Hang on. Okay. So you gotta slam the trunk. This probably needs an adjustment. Or it probably has a lot to do with these hood hinges. Trunk hinges, I mean. That are bent and tweaked. You know, it's got little gas struts back here. And I'm wondering if the gas struts were too much for the hinges, and that's why they break. Oh, here's the other side. I think we saw this. Here it is. So anyway, they got that to deal with. This was cool for its day. Back in the time when I used to do this stuff. still there, not broken. I want to pop the trunk, wanted to pop that. Yeah, okay. Trunk's latch, good. Okay, other side. Nice, tidy little car, right? Looks all factory to me. Doesn't look like it's ever been beat up, trashed. So, what's so bad about it, Dale? Well, the last owner, who owned it for many years, went through some water recently during our monsoon. And at the time that happened, I think they got water in the cylinder and they hydrolocked it a little because it blew a head gasket. And at the same time, the timing belt broke. So I knew that the timing belt broke because obviously it wouldn't start. Put a timing belt on it, brand new timing belt on it, and some associated parts and tensioners and stuff, thing fired right up. That being said, as I started driving it, I noticed condensation coming out of the exhaust. You can kind of see it. Woo! And you can smell it. It smells like antifreeze. And there's a little bit of water in the oil now, which wasn't there before, actually, which is weird. I checked. So, it's got 155, roughly, 1,000 miles on it. And NGK plug wires. But a nice, straight chassis. It's never been trashed up here or crashed. And expect to do either one head gasket, or you're probably going to do at least both while it's apart. It would make sense. Time belt's new under there, so you don't have to worry about that. The radiator was done about 25,000 miles ago, so that's relatively new. So there you go. That's what's wrong with this poor baby. Now, I'm thinking about fixing it before I sell it. That's the original van. I'm creative. Always have original stuff. So if I fix the head gaskets, which I'm very much considering doing because it's really worth saving on this car. I'm going to do it, the next person's going to do it. Then, of course, I'm going to raise the price. So, leather steering wheel. Let's go for a quick ride. AC's still blowing cold. Good. Put that baby in drive. Yeah, it's fine. The station I can listen to because this isn't really a song I did. Alright. Power steering feels good. It's got plenty of pep. Scoots along great. Punch it. Now for a little 2.5, or was it 2.8 V6, and for 1991, I'm gonna turn this off real quick. It's pretty impressive for its day. Gets you around town. It's starting to get hot there. Yeah, better take it back to the shop. So anywho, working air condition. Hey, cat, get out of the road. Yo, bitch, get out of the way. Get out. Okay, sorry. Yeah. If you put water in it, you can drive it short distances. But that's pretty much it. And I want to show you that. I'm going to pull over here so we can check it out one more time. And okay. Died. Yeah, I think it's getting kind of warm. Anyway, I'm gonna pull it up here to the shop. I don't want it to get too hot. I'm gonna call it a day. And I'll enjoy seeing the rest of this beast. Shut her down. But neat car, folks. I think all the power windows work too. So this door does not open from the outer handle. I can't remember this one. Yeah, this one does. So to get in, I've been climbing across the passenger side. But there you go. There's your ES250, folks. Lexi. And I think this thing, it is front wheel drive, but it would kind of cool to put some nice wheels on it maybe and drop it. Who knows? or just leave it all original and let it survive the way it is. I appreciate you watching. Hope you like our cars. Got plenty more coming. And maybe we'll even add some music again. I forgot today, sorry. Just forgot, busy. Have a good one. Peace out, my dogs.